So today we'll consider the conservation laws that are helpful to understand the distribution function in statistical mechanics. Okay. If you take in an isolated system consisting of large number of particles, let us take n number of particles, which are non-interacting particles. Okay. Non-interacting means they are free particles with respect to one another. Then the total number of particles in a system is given by n is equal to summation of ni, okay, where ni is the number of particles in ith state. So there will be large number of states, one first state, second state, 1, 2, 3, so on up to some ith state. If you take ni as a number of particles in ith state, it may be n1, n2, n3, so on up to nn, okay, if there are n number of states. In each state, there will be different number of particles. So if you take summation of all the particles in different states, that will give you total number of particles in the system. That is represented as capital N. So in an isolated system, so if you consider the isolated system, that means it is not exchanging the matter and energy with the surrounding. Isolated system means it is the system which does not exchange the matter and energy. Then it is observed that the summation of delta ni should be equal to zero. So delta ni means it is a derivative. If you take the derivative of ni's, that will be equal to zero, which is denoting the conservation of number of particles in the system. Okay, it is a conservation of matter, conservation of number of particles in the system. So what it represents basically, if you represent this summation of delta ni as dn1, d plus dn2 plus dn3, so on up to dnn, so it is representing the particles which are going from one state to another state. Suppose a change in n1 is going to take place. Suppose two states are there. Let us take simple example. Two states are there. Just I will share my screen. Suppose there are two states, okay, two states are there. So first state is, let us take E1, and second state, let us take it as E2. Okay. Second state is E2. Let us take the system is having total number of particles equal to 5. Okay, total number of particles is equal to 5. 5 particles are there. Initially, let us take 3 particles are in E2 state, one particle, second particle, third particle, and 2 particles are in E1 state. Okay, they are distinguishable particle. Initially, so we can take initially N1 is equal to 2 and N2 is equal to 3. The number of particles in first state is 2, number of particle in second state is 3. Okay. Then after certain time, let us take after certain time, one particle from E2 goes here. One particle from E2 goes here. Okay. So after certain time, you can get this particular situation. Okay. So let us take two energy states like this. Okay. After a certain time, E1 will have 3 particles. Okay. Idralli more particle aagtade. So because of the change in energy change aagi, one particle will go to the second state, and in E2, 2 particles will be there. So from going from this particular state to this particular state, this situation to this microstate, this microstate to this particular microstate. So what is the change in, that is summation, okay, summation sign I cannot write here, okay. So summation, okay. So summation of summation of, let us take D N I. Okay, D N subscript I should be equal to zero. This is the conservation law. Okay, so how this can be proved? So take the change number of particle in state one. What is the number of particles they have changed? Initially there are two particles and finally there are three particles. What is the change? It is equal to plus one. Corresponding to second state, how particles are changing? Initially there are three and finally there are two. It will be minus one. Okay, so that is definitely equal to zero. So it says that if the number of particles in one state decreases, that means that the number of particles will increase in the other state. And the number of particles cannot escape from the system. They must be inside the system. So the changes in the internal state may change. That can occur. But total number of particles, n, is always equal to 5. So here also 5 particles are there. Here also 5 particles are there. But there are changes in the microstate. So that change, summation of d and I must be equal to 0. The change in ni must be equal to 0. Okay, so that is how you can understand the concept of law of conservation of number of particles. Okay, so that is how you can understand. So then you will take the conservation of energy. Okay, similarly, the total energy of the system is also constant, which is given by E is equal to summation of ni into di. Okay, where ni represent number of particles in ith state, ei is the energy of ith state. Okay, so each particle in ith state will have the energy ei. Okay, so same thing you can find out here. Illi neevu consider madidru kuda, if three particles are there in a E1 state, what is the total energy of that state? It is 3E1. If two particles are there in E2 state, the energy of that state is 2E2. What is the total energy? It is 3E1 plus 2E2. If there is a change in states, state change agbodu. So final energy after certain variations in the state of the system, it may be 3E1 plus 2E2. Okay, like that energy may change, but it is observed that the summation of change in energy is always equal to zero. Summation of delta E is always equal to zero. This is nothing but conservation of energy. Okay, so summation of EI into delta NI equal to zero. We know that delta NI summed over 1 to N, it is always equal to zero. EI is basically constant for a given system. So E1, E2, E3, they are the energies of different systems. They are going to be constants. Okay. We know that delta Ni is going to be zero. Change in number of particles is zero. But energy of the particle may change. If one particle gains some energy, so other particle will lose some energy. Same amount of energy will be lost by them. Exchange of energy can be possible within the system, not with the surrounding. That is the meaning of this conservation of energy in the system of particle, in the isolated system. Okay, so if there is a work done, then only the variation of energy can take place in accordance with work energy theorem. The isolated system cannot do any work. So because of that, the energy of the system remains constant. So these two laws are very important in studying Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution function and other quantum mechanical distribution function also. Okay, one is conservation of number of particle, that is given by summation of delta Ni is always equal to zero. The conservation of energy is mathematically represented as summation of EI dNi is equal to zero. These two are called as conservation laws. Let us take one example to understand this conservation law or to find the energy of the system. Let us take this particular problem. A system consisting of 6 electrons has 3 energy states. So there are 6 electrons are there and 3 energy states are there. with energies 1/2 kT, 3 kT, and 5 kT. Three energy states are there. One energy state is having the energy 1/2 kT. The second energy state is having the energy 3/2 kT. The third energy state is having the energy 5/2 kT. Then out of six electrons, three electrons have opposite spin with respect to the other three electrons, and they obey Pauli's exclusion principle. This is the condition. Okay. So out of six electrons, three electrons have up spin and other three electrons are having opposite spin, that is down spin. And these electrons obey Pauli's exclusion principle. So it says that only two electrons can be accommodated in a one state, one energy state. So now we have to calculate the total energy of the system and average energy of the electrons. So first you have to understand the condition. Condition in kottidare, six electrons are there, three energy states are there, and the energy states are having the energies 1/2 kT, 3/2 kT, and 5/2 kT. And these six electrons are having opposite spins, three electrons with up spin, three electrons with down spin, and they should obey Pauli's exclusion principle. So according to that, if you distribute the electrons, so definitely in each state, two electrons can be accommodated. So first energy state only, one electron with up spin, another with down spin, two electrons can be accommodated. The second state, two more electrons with up and down spin. Third state only, a third electron. So in each state, two electrons can be accommodated. Now write the given quantities. What are the given quantities? N is equal to 6. Number of particles in the system is equal to 6. Energy of first state is 1/2 kT. So energy of second state is 3/2 kT. Energy of third state E3 is equal to 5/2 kT. So also three electrons have opposite spin with respect to the other three electrons. According to Pauli's exclusion principle, only one electron can occupy the given state. Okay. So given state means one up spin state, another down spin state. Since electron have two spins, up and down spin, each state can be occupied by two electrons with opposite spins. One state alli erdu electrons accommodate aagtide. There are three energy states, six electrons. So therefore, each energy state can accommodate two electrons. Now find the total energy. Okay. So therefore, all three states are occupied by two electrons each. In each state, two electrons are there. So therefore, N1 is equal to N2 is equal to N3, which is equal to 2. Okay. So N1 is 2, N2 is also 2, N3 is also 2. Okay. Now find the total energy. How to find the total energy? Total energy of the system is given by E total is equal to E1 into N1, energy of first state into number of particles in that state, plus E2 into N2, plus E3 into N3, energy of the state into number of particles in that. Okay. So substitute and calculate. So each state alli erdu electron ide, N1, N2, N3 are equal to 2. Therefore, 2 can be taken out. Energy of first state, E1 is 1/2 kT, E2 is 3/2 kT, E3 is 5/2 kT. Add them. So totally, you will get 9/2 kT. 5 plus 3, 8 plus 1. You will get 9/2 kT. 2 gets cancelled. You will get total energy of the system as 9 kT. You will get 9 kT as the total energy of the system. This is how we can calculate based on the condition given. Next, you find the average energy of the electron. Average energy of the electron is given by total energy of the system divided by number of electrons. That's all. Total energy of the electron divided by total number of electrons. It is the average value. So that is given by E average is equal to E1 N1 plus E2 N2 plus E3 N3 divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3. Otherwise, you can directly take E total by N. Okay. So E total is 9 kT. Total number of electrons are 6. So it is equal to 9 kT by 6. What is the value? So you will get average energy of this electron is equal to 3/2 kT. Okay. So therefore, we have got total energy of the system is 9 kT. Average energy of the electron is 3/2 kT. This is how some problem may be asked.